Hey guys, Johnny here, back with a brand new Call of Duty Mobile video. Today, I share with you guys all my tips and tricks to help you guys clear the brand new seasonal challenges fast in COD Mobile so you can unlock the cryo bomb, but also the brand new Cordite SMG. So just saying, I didn't know yesterday what I know today, and I was able to clear the bottom two fully in 2.5 hours and almost done with the Cordite. So let's start with the bottom two. Guys, before we start, make sure you subscribe to the channel for daily COD Mobile videos. So yeah, for the cryo bomb and the frame, you can do both at the same time. And the first tip I'm gonna give you guys is for the game modes, okay? So if you're working on kills, you wanna get a lot of kills fast. I did on Domination on Nuketown. The reason is in Domination Nuketown, everyone's always going to the middle and you get a lot of kills fast. Now, if you're working on score streaks, some viewers on my channel suggested to play Kill Confirm, and it actually worked really good for the 10 Hunter Killer drones. So what I suggest is go with the hardline perk so you cycle your score streaks fast. Go with the three cheapest score streaks and then spam, okay? Spam, and you're gonna get tons of Hunter Killer drones, guys. Because in Kill Confirm, you get lots of points by picking up the dog tags, and it actually really works. So alternate the game modes, guys. You want some kills, go Domination Nuketown. You want some score streaks, go back to Kill Confirm, all right? So the rest is just using some specific perks and get some kills. So you equip the perk, don't forget, and go back to Domination on Nuketown. You're gonna get 20 kills in a game. Now, I thought that one was gonna be hard, but I pretty much got it in two games. Again, in Domination Nuketown, throw your trip mines near the left side or right side of the greenhouse, left side of the yellow house. People keep coming there to go to B. Your trip mines will trigger for sure. Now, at the same time, you can do these. So equip the right operator skill, and you're just gonna do them while working on the bottom part. So it's not very hard. Just equip the purifier. Once you're done with the 10 kills, switch to the next one, dead machine. Once you're done, switch to the next one. So there's not much to say, guys, but I started with the bottom two because you can do both at the same time. And I actually ended up finishing both at the same time. On the last game, I finished both of these. All right, now we're gonna go for the Cordite SMG, guys. And this is all in 1v1 duel mode. And I got some tips for you guys for the 1v1 duels, stuff that I didn't know yesterday and I know today. Would have made my life a bit easier. So the first challenge, there's nothing to it. Just kill 30 enemies. So just play some 1v1s and you're gonna get used to the game mode at the same time. But first tip, guys, this is my very first tip. Don't do what I did. When you go to your game mode selection, guys, don't click on 1v1 duels, because if you do 1v1 duels, you'll get saloon, but also you'll get kill house. And guys, I'm not gonna lie, kill house is a freaking mess. It is not the place to, I mean, people are camping at their end. People go on the tower with the melee weapon. It is horrible, guys. It's the opposite of playing. People just camp. That would be my first mistake. If I knew yesterday, I would have gone straight to the other way to play 1v1. So instead of picking 1v1 duel, go to saloon. And then all your games will be 1v1 on saloon. So no kill house, guys. It's gonna be so much better. Less camping. The games will be faster. You'll lose less time even when you lose. So work on your kills. On saloon is gonna be fast. You will meet very, very, very quick. And then you're gonna have to start working on your weapon kills. 15 kills with the shotgun. So now it's gonna depend if you're good with the shotgun or if you struggle with the shotgun. But my favorite shotguns are the ones that do lots of damage in one burst. So if you have the KRM, of course, but if you don't, try the BY-15, guys. The striker is horrible. The burst shotgun, I'm not a big fan, but I really like the BY-15. It's a very, very good shotgun. Now for your shotgun loadout, I recommend using lightweight, guys. Also, use dead silence on all your loadouts, except one. I'll talk about loadouts later, but use dead silence because you don't want your opponent, like if he didn't see you and you're behind him, you don't want to alert him. So use dead silence, guys. And then if you can get an easy kill, just take it. And then ghost, use ghost. You don't want to appear on the mini map if you don't have to, all right? So ghost, dead silence, lightweight for the shotgun. And then if you're really good, what you can do is get a few kills, let your opponent win the first round, and then choose shotguns for the second round, because the first round is going to be tougher. If you play shotgun and your opponent's using AR or SMG, you're at a disadvantage. So if you lose the first round, you're going to select shotgun on the second round, and then it's going to be shotgun versus shotgun. Now, once you're done with the shotgun kills, you're going to have to use sniper rifles. And then I know some guys will be stuck there for a while. If you struggle with snipers, you're just going to get better with time. But there are still some snipers that are more friendly. If you miss your shots a lot, I would recommend using... Guys, I did it yesterday. The M21. The M21 is not bad at all. I got some gameplay for you guys. You can scope in and shoot. You shoot very fast. You very, very accurate sniper. And then you kill in two shots if you hit your shots. I did really good with the M21, so if you're struggling, you can try it. But also the Arctic 50, guys. The Arctic 50, you can stay scoped in, you can hit a few shots, and you will get some one-shot, one-kills with the Arctic 50. With the M21, most of the time, you're gonna have to hit multiple shots. But yeah, if your opponent's moving well, and then the same strat, like, seriously, you don't have a choice. If you play sniper versus something else, you're gonna struggle maybe on the first round. But then on the second round, it's going to be sniper versus sniper. The problem, though, is sniper versus sniper, like in the good old battle royale snipers only, people run around with pistols, guys. And there's nothing you can do. Just keep playing until you get 15 kills, guys. It might take a few games, but like again, there's no shortcut to that one. You need to get 15 sniper kills. So use the sniper that's going to give you the best chance. If you're good, if you hit your shots, well, go for the DLQ or whatever you like. But if you're struggling, go with the fast fire, Arctic 50, M21. It worked for me, and I'm sure it's going to work for you. I'm not going to talk about loadouts. Just use your favorite sniper loadouts. But usually, people like Agile. But I would still say Dead Silence and Ghost. Now, the next one is win games. And again, I got some tips today, guys. Pick the right loadouts, guys. It's going to help you get some easy wins. First loadout, I would recommend use your weapon that you're very comfortable with. But I found out that shotgun gave me an edge because a lot of players are not so good with the shotguns. So loadout number one, I made a shotgun loadout just for that. I don't usually use shotguns in rank, but I found out a lot of players are not super good with the shotguns. So if you're a bit better than average, it's gonna give you a huge edge. So use whatever you like for the first round, but if you lose, pick shotguns on the second round, and it's gonna give you a big edge because a lot of players are bad. Use lightweight to run faster. And I got a lot of easy wins with shotguns, guys. Then I recommend using the axe on the secondary because, guys, I found out while playing a lot yesterday, when you win the first round, a lot of players will go melee weapon on the second round. So you need to have a good melee loadout. The axe got more range than the knives. So if you have the axe, use it. And again, lightweight on the same loadout. So you're gonna run faster with your melee. And if they don't see you, once again, you can chase them and knife them or axe them in the back. You have to have the right loadout and be ready to play some melee action. Now, second loadout, guys, is the only one I say don't use Dead Silence. Get ready to have a rocket launcher loadout, guys, because also a lot of players, when they lose the first round, they will go no primary on the second round. So you have to fight with rocket launchers. And people use the flak jacket, so have a loadout with flak jacket, rocket launcher. You take less explosion damage. You will have an edge in battle if they don't have it. And the last perk is demo expert. You're gonna deal 25% extra damage with explosives. So have a rocket launcher loadout to be able to counter these rocket launcher guys. So once again, rocket launcher on one of your loadout. And that only loadout you don't use Dead Silence, Demo Expert, and Flak Jacket, just to be able to counter these. Now, of course, your last three loadouts will be your best loadouts. So have a good loadout for Sniper. Whatever you like to use, use your Sniper loadout with your best perks, your best attachments and everything. And then, I guess, AR loadout and SMG loadout, that's what I use. And that should give you an edge in battle, guys. And then all you have to do is work on these 5 wins. Then you're gonna have to do 10 pistol kills. That's another thing. On my sniper loadout, I use my MW11 with extended mag, guys. Laser sight. Extended mag on the MW11 is very good. I had some pistol matchups yesterday. The J358 versus the MW11. And I won my matchup. because I had tons of ammo, shoots fast if your opponent's moving well. I like the MW11 always, but use whatever you're comfortable with. Just be sure you have one in one of your loadouts with your favorite attachments. Now, maybe one last tip. I wouldn't do that, but I saw that on Reddit. Some guys are begging for free wins in the game chat. Like, if you're struggling, you can ask your opponent, please let me win. Tell him it's your last win and maybe you're gonna get a free one. I know some guys are just running around and helping people. They let people win, but good luck, guys. You can win legit. Just play as hard as you can. Get the right loadouts and play to win, guys. Once again, don't go on Kill House. It's horrible. All right, thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the tip. Hit the like if you did. Subscribe to the channel for daily COD Mobile videos. I will see you guys in the next one. Take care.